Hi everyone! Today I'm making seamlessly repeating patterns in GIMP. I drew these lineart drawings in one of my Inktober videos in my sketchbook, then I scanned them, and now I'm turning them into patterns I'll use for coloring pages, envelopes and a calendar. And I might also put them up in my Redbubble shop. The process is mostly the same as in my previous repeating pattern GIMP video, where I used flower watercolor paintings. I've already cleaned up the scanned pictures and adjusted the levels. I'm starting with the nesting dolls. The dolls are not all in the same line, so I'm fixing that first. You can pull down the ruler and then select the drawing you want to move with the free select tool. Cut it out by pressing ctrl x and paste it back with ctrl v. Now I'm moving it so it's on the same level with the first doll. And I'm turning the cutout into a new layer. I'll cut out one of the dolls and I'll bring it back later when I make the repeating unit. I'm moving the rest of the dolls closer to the first row. When the dolls are on different layers, I can move them where I want. The rulers help me see if the first and the third row are in the same line. When I'm happy with the arrangement, I'll merge all the layers into one again. I'm cropping the image, but leaving some blank space in all the edges. That will turn into an empty space in the middle for the last doll I cut out before. To make a repeating unit, go to Layer, Transform, Offset and click on Offset by x divided by 2, y divided by 2. Now I'm bringing back the final doll and it doesn't really fit in, so I have to rearrange some of the other dolls to make room for it. I'm doing the same thing again, cutting them out, pasting back and then moving them in a new layer. The repeating unit is now finished and I'll show you what it looks like when the pattern is repeated. Go to Filters, Map, Tile. Increase the size and click OK. And so the doll pattern is finished. I'm doing the same thing for the feathers and adding another two feathers in the middle. The leaf pattern is a little different because I'll make the two drawings overlap. After making the unit with the empty space in the middle, I'm choosing the white background in the second drawing with the fuzzy select tool. It will only select the white in the background, not inside the lines of the leaves. Go to Layer, Transparency, Add Alpha Layer to add a transparent layer underneath. Now remove the selected white background with Ctrl X. It seems I lost some of the white inside the leaves, so I need to undo and fix up those lines. Now it works. I'm copy-pasting it into the repeating unit. Make sure you have the drawing selected, not the background, when you copy it. And now I can position it any way I want to. It can overlap with the other drawing and the pattern will look like it's just one continuous drawing. This is what it looks like tiled. The last one is a Hamsa hand with some flowers and things around it. It seems to be a little tilted, so I'm using the rulers and the rotate tool to fix it. After transforming, I'm copy-pasting some of the little flowers and moving them around in the middle to fill the space. As I said, I'll turn these patterns and some earlier ones into a calendar, but I also updated the Ethnic Girl coloring calendar from last year for 2018. It's now available in my Etsy shop, you'll find the link below. It's a printable calendar, so when you buy it, you'll get a PDF download you can print out. I'll also post a video on how to make a calendar with Microsoft Word and GIMP, so stay tuned for that. Thanks for watching!